Hi, I'm Deepak Vasisht. First of all, I'm very thankful to ISTC Chairperson Dr. Preetpal Singh and other coordinators to allow me to give my presentation through this video presentation. So let's start. My paper topic is Breaking into Social Nervous System and Architecture for Reality Mining. I'm currently pursuing BTech from Dronacharya College of Engineering, Gurgaon, which is MDU affiliated. I'm an Indian. So how it begins? As former President of India, APJ Abdul Kalam stated, we have enough of water, enough of food, enough of money, enough of everything except the ability to agree and move forward. We find out nursing a strong and effectual society is a challenge that takes us back to our independence when the newly emerging power requires dealing with social and environmental problems. The therapy then was to contrive consolidated network that delivers hygienic food, eradicates waste, provide energy, facilitate transportation and other healthcare and education services. But these century-old solutions deals with social and environmental problems are progressively obsolete. But still, we are doing the same. Our government just modifies it and presents new 5-year plan without considering today's social dynamics. To overcome this, we build dynamic network self-regulatory system that take into account complex social interfaces based on reality mining. Let's take a quick look on some of the earlier uses of reality mining. Reality mining has been used in managing traffic congestions, where GPS technologies in cars have been used to find out and predict congestions hours and days before. Similarly, mobiles have been used by Indian IB to track down the terrorist activities. It has also been used by advertising industries to create first publicity blitz. There are many other fields where this concept has been used. Let us talk about our model, which is based on Jacob Maroner's model as stated in Who Shall Survive. How we develop is created a 3-level architecture, clients, intermediate and server. At level 2, client and sensors are implemented that provides all communicational traces to dedicated server. These sensors are connected to 2 servers, dedicated servers and intermediate server. We have used MIT Media FunUp framework for this purpose as it was easy and it was compatible with our system. At level 1, intermediate server, that is PC, home, desktop and even your normal computer can be used to backup logs in case dedicated server fails. Primary level filtration is also implemented in this level. At level 0, dedicated server which analyzes all data received from beneath levels implements it and filters out all the queries so that we can generate a model for further manual analysis. We have used this to create demograph for 77 student participants. And believe me, it's very difficult to convince a person to grant his or her personal data. So we have to bargain with them. We provide them free internet services for pure 1 month. Now, let's see, this graph demonstrates the 77 people result. In this, subgroups are formed on the basis of their member interactions. Every group is shown in different color. The demograph is auto generated by our system, and we found out that 90% of these clues are similar to real life groups, like student traveling same bus route likely to take the same route and have same topics for conversation, and they have same sort of things in common. The rate of influence by a person in same clue is higher as compared to person in another clue. Like when a person in red dot buys a latest smartphone, suddenly the pattern of buying new mobile increases in that clue. Actually, it's normally we do copying each other's. We have also find results that indicates that every clue has a most influential person who is a key spread information, idea, and even gossips. It can be used for spreading netters and other things. This information can be used by agencies like government agencies to define what a particular group needs. It can be also used to maintain hazardous situations and to define rehabilitation centers. We have given an idea to develop a system that can be used to provide rehabilitation systems when a hazard occurs. Thank you, and any query you can mail me.